Do you guys remember when you were kids and company used to come over and your mom used to like freak out the entire weekend beforehand?
Company is coming. Company is coming. I said dust. Does this look like you dusted? I don't think so. Do it again. Company. Who put this pillow here? This pillow doesn't go here. What are you, a barbarian? What, were you raised on a farm? You can't just leave your cup out. You want it to look like people live here? We're gonna make it look like nobody lives here.
Yeah, I actually relate to this now. I also understand why my mom used to get so mad when I wouldn't take the chicken out of the freezer to defrost when I got home from school. Anyways, we have guests coming to stay with us for the holidays as well as to meet baby Miles, but I'm gonna bring you along with me on my cleaning routine for guests and share some of my favorite tips and tricks for you. Go. Once I get started, one of the first things I like to do is just go around the house and pick up all of the clutter because you really can't effectively clean when you have stuff all over. And there's a lot of stuff all over my house right now with a newborn and with DIYs I'm working on and with holiday stuff. So I'm just going to clear off all of my surfaces, pick up all of my floors so that I can effectively focus on cleaning. Okay, one tip I have for just cleaning in general is as you're going around and picking up clutter, instead of constantly running each thing to exactly where it goes and running back and forth between all of your rooms, I kind of make piles as I'm going of items. So like this is stuff that needs to go to the office, this is stuff that's gonna need to go upstairs, this is stuff for the kitchen, this is my craft stuff that I'm gonna put in my craft bin in the attic. So I kind of like pile it as I go and then I just take one big trip at the end. So one room I obviously like to focus on when guests are coming is going to be the guest bathroom, especially if you're having overnight guests, that's where they're going to be staying. So obviously I'm gonna give it the normal wipe down that I would usually do, but when I have overnight guests coming, there's a few little extra things I like to do. I like to always make sure that I'm putting out extra toilet paper, extra paper towels in case they need those things, as well as some clean towels. It just makes people feel a little more comfortable when they have all the stuff they need. So one other thing that I like to do is also just make a little basket of sort of like toiletries that you might need that maybe you forgot. And all the products actually that I'm using here is from the company called Public Goods, which was cool enough to sponsor this video. And I wanna tell you a little bit about them because I think you guys are really going to like it. So the way that Public Goods works is they sell home products, beauty products, bath products, but they cut out the middleman and sell directly to consumers in a membership-based model. So essentially you pay a one-time flat fee and you get all of the products at a really honest price. And when I say honest prices, I mean things like $4.50 for shampoo and $4.25 for dish soap. What I think is really cool about Public Goods, besides the fact that you can get clean products at a really affordable price, is that the packaging is just really clean and simple. Lots of times home products have really like kind of obnoxious loud packaging because they're trying to grab your attention when you're shopping. But because Public Goods just sells directly to you, they have really simple, like clean, elegant designs. You can make a basket that really looks nice and sort of like elegant and refined, and you don't have like tons of colorful packaging. Because I'm collaborating with Public Goods for this video, I have a really great offer for you guys to try a bunch of their stuff for free. There is a code in my description box down below that is going to get you a free travel kit so you can try a wide variety of their products out. You can sort of get a feel for how great their products are. Now while I'm decluttering, I kind of like declutter more than I usually would if it's just a normal clean, because when guests come, they always bring stuff, whether they're bringing like presents or food or their baggage or their purse or whatever. So things that usually I might leave out, like some candles or some decorative stuff, I might stash that away and declutter even extra so that there's just sort of more space. Remember, when you're cleaning for guests, you want to think about the areas that your guests are going to be in your house. This is not the time to get sidetracked and decide you're going to organize your entire closet in your bedroom, because your guests aren't gonna see in there. So focus on the things that matter. All right, when it comes to organizing your cupboards, I kind of try to focus on the cupboards that I know my guests are gonna use the most so I don't get totally overwhelmed trying to organize everything. So we have this one cupboard that is where we keep like our coffees and our tea. It's sort of a hot mess right now, so I just wanna organize it so it's really easy for my guests to find their coffee. I put all my decaf coffees in one, then I have kind of like assorted coffees. We've got some tea, some hot chocolate, and I just condense everything so it's easy for them to find and it's organized. One spot that I always clean up before guests come is our sort of like little mini entryway here. We have a hook and you can see we have tons of jackets and hats and all sorts of stuff hanging here because Michael and I use this space a lot. But when guests come, then they have nowhere to hang their jackets. So I always declutter this right before we have company come over so they have a place to hang their purses, to put their jackets, and it's not like strewn about in the living room. All right, another good tip for guests, especially unexpected guests, is what I call the clutter basket. And I keep one in each room of my house. It's basically just a basket where you can throw like extra clutter that's just sort of hanging around at a moment's notice, and then you can just sort gonna stash it in a closet, in a cupboard, or put it like underneath a coffee table or whatever. It's just a great way to quickly pick up clutter in a pinch. So I'm kind of decluttering and wiping down surfaces as I go. And once that's all done, I move on to floors. And here's my trick for floors. Usually you wanna do like a vacuum right before your guests come, because especially with dogs and kids, floors get dirty really quick. But the last thing you wanna be doing is like a deep vacuum 20 minutes before your guests come. So what I do is usually like a day or two before, I will go in and do a really big vacuum where I'm like getting all the crevices and I'm moving the furniture. And then, you know, the morning of or the night before, I will do a quick vacuum. And we have a little robot vacuum, so I'll just run him the morning that guests come. But if you don't, you just pull out your vacuum, do a really quick vacuum, basically just sort of touching up. And that way the morning your guests arrive, you're not like running around trying to vacuum behind all of your furniture. Final touch before your company arrives is, personally for me, I always like to add a little bit of scent. So I do two things. The first thing I like to do is just spritz any upholstery with a scent. So I'm just taking a little of that essential lavender oil that came from my public goods order, and I'm just gonna add like one or two drops to some water and spritz that on basically any upholstery, the things that kind of like hold the bad smells, to give it a nice fresh scent. And then obviously I always like to light a candle or two. I feel like it doesn't just help to make the room smell nice, but I feel like it just kind of like looks nice as well in the space. All right guys, that does it. Thanks for cleaning with me for guests. I hope that some of my tips that I use when company is coming will help you guys, especially this holiday season when lots of people are coming to visit. Don't forget that I have that free offer for public goods to get a free travel kit with your purchase. Again, the information and the code for that is down below, but it's a free travel kit to try a bunch of their stuff out. As always, thank you so much for stopping by and watching. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day, and I will see you all in my next video.